So I've been spending some free time listening to Kurt Angle's new podcast, The Kurt Angle Show, and I've recently completed a read of his book. It got me thinking about just how legendary Kurt's professional wrestling career was. To me, he was the GOAT, the greatest of all time, and I'm going to tell you all of the reasons why. By now, Kurt's 1996 Olympic gold medal win is no secret. It's well known and it's what he built his career on. But what may be lesser known is all the work it took to get to that point. He spent his entire life dedicated to the sport of amateur wrestling. The fire only grew bigger after the tragic loss of his father. The lifelong goal was reached in Atlanta in 1996 when he finally won a gold medal at the Olympics. It's become a bit of a running joke at this point that he won it with a broken freaking neck, but that really was a big deal. It was so dangerous that it could easily have left him paralysed. But his desire to win and fight through the pain led to his success at the 1996 Olympics. Arguably, Kurt Angle had one of the fastest transitions from one sport to another. Just months after beginning training on how to become a professional wrestler, he found himself on the road full time for the WWF, making his debut at Survivor Series on November 1999 against Sean Stasiak. He debuted as a heel, playing off his gold medal. He remained undefeated until January of the following year. Just months into his professional wrestling career, he found himself having captured the lights of the Intercontinental Championship and the European title. But at No Mercy in 2000, Angle won his first ever World Heavyweight Championship just less than a year after his debut in the WWF. Over the years, we've seen Kurt's ability to adapt as a performer. He started off as a heel, taking himself too seriously, then he transitioned into a goofy character. Other forms of his character we've seen Kurt adapt to was under the general manager role on SmackDown in 2004 and again later on in 2017 for Monday Night Raw. We've seen a wrestling machine in ECW and on SmackDown prior to that when he even won the World Heavyweight Championship in 2006. And then in TNA, we've seen him as a mafia boss during his time in Total Nonstop Action. No matter the year or the promotion, Angle has always had the ability to reinvent himself and adapt to the times, whether it be in WWE, TNA, or even a brief run on the independent circuit. So, following on from my last point, his willingness to transform has seen some legendary moments throughout his career. Everybody will always remember him wearing a little cowboy hat while singing Come By Yard will forever be iconic, as well as Milk Mania segment where he milked down the Alliance, Stephanie McMahon, Shane McMahon, Stone Cold Steve Austin amongst other WCW and ECW stars. Kurt had the ability to do comedy or be as serious as needed when the timing was right. He was never afraid to make himself look goofy if it was right for business, and that is something we need more from wrestlers in today's times. He said it himself during his WWE Hall of Fame speech. As great as it was having an amazing match, it's the moments, the segments, that people will remember. And you know what? Kurt is actually right on that point. As well as his legendary segments, he's no stranger to having quality matches. When Kurt Angle was on the card, you knew he wouldn't give anything less than 100%. There are hundreds of great matches Kurt had throughout his career, whether that was in WWE or in TNA. His matches with Chris Benoit were guaranteed technical masterpieces, as well were his encounters with Brock Lesnar. Eric Bischoff said it best, he couldn't have a bad match even if his life depended on it. You only have to look at his matches with the likes of The Undertaker or later on with AJ Styles in TNA to see how gifted he was. To me, one match stands out in particular, and that was his match with Shawn Michaels at WrestleMania 21. that may go down as the greatest WrestleMania match of all time. If you haven't watched it yet, I highly recommend you go change that. His dedication to succeed in everything he did made him one of the most well-respected names in wrestling history. He won a gold medal with a broken neck, but he also wrestled professional wrestling matches with a broken neck amongst many other injuries throughout his career. Kurt was always willing to work through any pain he had just to please the fans. No matter how hurt he was, he gave his heart to the sport of professional wrestling. One story sticks out in my mind is when he broke his neck. He was originally not supposed to wrestle against Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania 19, but a kid that Kurt knew in his neighbourhood said how much he would have loved to see Kurt Angle wrestle, so Kurt changed his mind and wrestled with a broken neck against Brock Lesnar. Kurt Angle gave his heart to the sport of professional wrestling, and that to me is why Kurt Angle is the GOAT. So what are your thoughts on Kurt Angle? Were you a fan of him, or were you not throughout his career? Let me know in the comments section down below. If you're feeling generous, please consider subscribing to the channel. I am trying to hit 5,000 subscribers before the end of the year, so each subscribe will be a great help. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like. It does help me out a lot. My name is Jamie, and I thank you for watching.